Medical is one of the areas where I think all the hype that 3D printing has is fully founded. You know, prosthetics, you know, if there's a soldier, you're replacing limbs, you're replacing organs, 3D printing will play a big role in all that.
My name is Frank Quinlisk. Our company is Profound 3D, and my position is vice president. We've been in the 3D print industry for 3 years, which doesn't sound like a tremendous amount of time, but so much has changed in 3 years. It's been crazy. I just had a customer that came by, or a prospect that came by, and they're working with a charity out of Africa. And what they're doing is this now makes prosthetics available to these kids that have no opportunity to work with a prosthetic. I mean, they can build a replacement arm or a replacement hand, you know, for $50 as far as the total print costs. This enables them to be able to make prosthetics on a much smaller scale at a much lower price.
Most of our printers print at a layer level, somewhere in just a few microns. The predominant ones we use are either 2 or 4 thousandths of an inch thick per layer. So they're very small build lines. This is a piece that everyone's in the 3D industry seen. It's been around forever. It's impossible to make with traditional manufacturing. There's a stairwell and double helix inside. The way we build them, we can also do them in that size. The bricks, the stairwell, the double helix, our logo, our name, it's all in there.
We've had people talk about, and we've seen people talk about using it with organic material on higher end systems, where you'll be able to build replacement parts using that type of like organic material like that. So yeah, there's advances being made with it all the time. Can't do it with some of these desktop units, but that's what's happening, is that gap is closing.